Hey, Holden Chapel Kids! As we continue to study the book of Revelation and the vision that God gave to John, we will learn about how much Jesus loves the church and wants people to turn away from their sin and turn to Him. Before we dig into God's Word, though, let's worship our great God and His reckless love for us.
Singing over me. the splendor of a king, clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great
activity time. Today's activity is called church building. Before you begin, gather different materials that can be used to build with, such as Legos or blocks, craft sticks and tape, pretzels and raisins, graham crackers and frosting. To do this activity, have everyone choose one of the building materials that you gathered. Each person will make a church building using the materials they chose. When everyone is done, compare and contrast the churches you made. What is similar? What is different? Pause the video while you complete this activity, then press play when you are ready. Have fun! I would love to have seen the church buildings your family built. I'm sure they are all as unique as the people who made them. In our Bible story today, Jesus appeared to John in a vision and told him 7 different messages to send to 7 different churches. Let's find out what those messages were.
The Apostle John was on the island of Patmos when he had a vision of Jesus. Jesus told John to write down a message for 7 churches. So that is what John did. To the church in Ephesus, you do not love well like you did when you first believed. Turn back and love like you used to. To the church in Smyrna, you are poor and are suffering, but really you are rich. You may face prison or death, but do not be afraid. To the church in Pergamum, you are faithful to me, and you tell others about me even when it is hard, but not everyone in the church is doing the right thing. Some people are living like those who do not believe. Turn away from your sin and turn back to me. To the church in Thyatira, I know about your love, faithfulness, and service. You do not give up. But there is a wicked woman who teaches things that are not true, and some of you believe her. I will punish her and those who follow her teaching. Many of you do not follow her. Keep believing the truth until I come. To the church in Sardis, people think you are alive, but you are actually dead. You used to have a strong faith, but now you are weak. Wake up, be ready for my return. Turn from your sin and remember the gospel. To the church in Philadelphia, you have little power, but you listen to me and obey my word, and I am coming soon. Be ready and keep believing. To the church in Laodicea, you are lukewarm, not hot or cold, so you are not good for anything. I will spit you out of my mouth. You think you are rich, but you are actually poor, blind, and naked. Jesus told them to come to him, and he would make them rich. He would make them see and would put clothes on them. Jesus said, "See, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in to him and eat with him, and he with me." Jesus will reward every faithful and obedient believer. John wrote, "Let anyone who has ears to hear listen to what the Spirit says to the churches." Jesus loves the church. His message to 7 local churches called them to turn away from their sin and remain faithful to him. We can learn from those churches. Through the church, Jesus helps believers work together to do God's plan.
Let's dig into God's word and find out what God wants us to learn from this story. After each question is read, pause the video and talk about your answers together. Then press play when you are ready. First question. Jesus had 7 messages for 7 churches. Who is the church? Did you notice that I asked who is the church and not what is the church? When people think of a church, they often think about a building. But John wasn't writing to a building made of stone or wood. The local church is a group of believers who live near one another, are committed to one another, and who gather regularly to worship Jesus, serve others, and share the gospel. John recorded the messages Jesus gave him so he could send them to the people who believed in and worshiped Jesus in 7 cities. Our church, Holden Chapel, is made up of believers who have trusted in Jesus. If you believe that Jesus died so your sins could be forgiven and that God raised him from the dead, then you are part of the church too. Next question. Why did Jesus send the messages to the 7 churches? Jesus loves the church, and he wants the church to be a part of his plan. The messages Jesus sent to the churches may seem harsh to some people, but these warnings were given out of love. Jesus wasn't telling the churches it was too late. He was reminding them that it wasn't too late. Jesus was willing to discipline his people so they would turn away from sin and turn to him. Hebrews 12 explains it this way. Do not make light of the Lord's discipline, and do not lose heart when he rebukes you, because the Lord disciplines those he loves, and he punishes everyone he accepts as a son. Our fathers disciplined us for a little while as they thought best. But God disciplines us for our good, that we may share in his holiness. The messages that John wrote down for the seven churches almost 2,000 years ago have been recorded in the book of Revelation so that we too may learn from them. Jesus is still encouraging the church today to repent, to turn to him, and to remain faithful.
There's no space that his love can't reach. There's no place where we can't find peace. There's no end to amazing grace. Take me in with your arms spread wide. Take me in like an orphan child. Never let go, never leave my side. Resurrection song. This is my hallelujah.